now in Italy. Very, very welcome in this city and region, Marche and Pesaro. You have already enjoyed the beautiness, the beauty of the Italian garden of the school. This is a very important school for agriculture. You will be introduced to the history of the school, to the reason, to the results of this school, as well as to the role of the Academia Agraria that has been the origin of the foundation of the school. But, first of all, let me thank anyway the city of Pesaro, that is here represented by the responsible of sustainability of the city council. First of all, I want to thank this city, because for me it's a new place of residence. I was a resident in Ancona for long, but now it is 2-3 years that I am a resident in Pesaro, and I enjoy very much to be a new citizen of this very beautiful city. It's the city of music, it's the city of bikes. It's literally in the place when you enter in the city. And I'm very glad to give the microphone to the authority of this city, the responsible. Non vuole?
Sì, sì.
No, perché loro mi hanno detto di fare così.
Quindi, ok,
well, to the responsible of the sustainability of the city council, the assessore, in Italian it's called assessore, this role of Franca Foroni. Thank you very much for being here.
Thank you. And so I try to speak English. I'm a German teacher, and when I speak English, I make the confusion between the two languages. But I try to speak English. I hope that you understand what I say. Okay, good evening to everyone, to everybody, and welcome to Pesaro. Mr. Sotte has introduced me, and he has said I'm a councillor in the town of Pesaro. I represent the town, and I'm a councillor for the environment and sustainability. Pesaro is a quite small town. It has 95,000 inhabitants. This town is on the Adriatic coast, on the Adriatic Sea, and it is the town of music. Rossini, the compositor Rossini, is born here, and the town of Bari. We have 95 kilometers of bike street. That's very important for us, that people in Pesaro move by bike. It's very important for the pollution, for the other problems of the environment. As teacher, I know this program, this European programs for discussion about themes. In this case, the theme is rural areas and agriculture. I think that's very important. The European programs are very important for all the countries. First of all, to exchange ideas, good practice, ways of dealing with problems and issues, and to move people and ideas and intelligences. I think that's very important. The theme of your meeting is agriculture and development of rural areas, I think. It's a very important theme, a very important topic, I think, in Europe, but in the world. You are here in a high school, conflitto agrario cechi. This is a wonderful villa, a wonderful structure in Pesaro, in this AI school. In this school were qualified people, in this school were prepared qualified people to work in agriculture in this field. And I hope that you have, how long do you stay here?
How long?
3 days. 3 days that you have nice days in the province of Pesaro Urbino. This is the province of Pesaro Urbino. This is the Urbino is a university city, as Ancona, and is the capital of Renaissance, Rinascimento of in Italian. And so I want to wish you a good work and to have a nice time in our town. And I thank you for your attention. Good work.
Thank you very much for your participation to our event. I consider that it is very important that the cities participate actively to our discussion, because well, we consider that rural development is not a matter only of the countryside, but also a problem of the cities. Being in Pesaro is the second city in region Mark. The first is Ancona, with around 100,000 inhabitants. And this is for the European Union classified as a sensibly rural region, both in terms of region as a whole and in terms of all the provinces, which is not the case, for instance, for Tuscany, that is that has a very well known rurality, but Florence is not classified as rural, evidently, because it's a It's important also in this region that we are remote by from other big centers. Rome is around 3 hours far from here. Bologna, that is not actually a metropolitan area, it's around 500,000 people, is anyway, you have experienced how far is Bologna, because they arrived from Bologna airport to here by train. And so you understand that also remoteness is crucial in rurality. And we are very proud to consider this region for its history as a very, very rural region in the past, but also in the future. This is a characteristic of this region that will never be, lost. Okay. The second presentation is a presentation of the school that have co-organized with us this event. I am very, very happy that the school has taken this opportunity with a very, very, very serious concern. I'm very glad that the dean and the vice dean have collaborated very actively to the success of our initiative. So the floor is to Professor Pamela Carducci, which is has been asked to present the school where you are participating to this event.
Good evening, I'm Pamela Carducci, I'm a teacher at this school, and I thank you all to be here this evening. I'd like to present our school, our institute, and its activities and its funds. The institute is out in the historic Villa Caprile, surrounded by the green hills of the natural park of San Bartolo. It has an agricultural area farm of 25 hectares, 15 hectares of cultivated areas, so divided, 11 hectares of land. 2 of vineyards, 1.5 of olive trees, 1 of orchards, 10 hectares of wood, gardens and greenhouses, vegetable garden, and the floor ones where exercises are carried out. Sorry. There is the existence of an experimental Venus, a novel grove, a potato, and an ancestral variety plant. Okay, as you see, you can see this is our villa. The building complex has very diversified uses. For example, in this part we have the office of our headmaster, other offices, administration, and library. On the west wing there is an IT classroom, and it houses the section of a boarding school. In fact, in this school we welcome 46 students in the boarding school, and they live here from Monday to Friday, and they have lunch and dinner, and they sleep here. In the morning they go to school, in the afternoon they study. So, in the east wing there is other classrooms of the institute, and we have many laboratories, agronomy, mechanics and physics, and there is the Stucco Gallery, where we will have lunch later, and you will see it, and in that hall is located, it's a class for disabled students. We host more than 1,200 students, and they continuously enjoy the green spaces that the school is equipped with, having the opportunity to constantly spend naturalistic and educational cultural experience together. You can see this is one of our teachers, and you will have dinner tomorrow at the Miniera.
Yes.
He is the owner of the restaurant. You will see him tomorrow night. And these are our students. Okay, some pictures. The lady over there is our headmaster mistress, Donatella Giuliani. She's not here, and she sends her greetings for me, so she's sorry she can't be here. And the man is our cook. Some of you have already had lunch today. Our students, while they are working, and our students during the lecture about evolution. Our school offers extracurricular activities such as school trips, field trips, to wineries, to oil mills, to dairies, and so on. We offer study periods abroad. For example, next November, next month, our students will leave for Dublin. And next February, another part of the students will leave for Edinburgh. La musica. Okay. Okay, so we offer training in the other European agricultural institutes, visit to art exhibitions, business internship, because our students alternate study and work, so they experience this internship at school during the holidays, summer holidays. We prepare any kind in the school gardens for water games. We offer sporting activities and skiing holidays. Okay, these are some pictures about school trips. We are in a winery. The students are listening to the owner of the winery. There are some members, and they are having a sommelier course. So they taste, they smell wine. In this photo they are joking, of course, they are working, but it is a joke. And this is our headmistress during a school trip. She is crossing a bridge in Slovenia. And we have many laboratories, sciences, chemistry, physics, zootechnics, agronomy. We have a winery where we produce wine, and we have also oil culture, education to legality, exams for ECDL license, and exams for the training tests to improve the level of the language of our students. That's all. Thank you very much.
Another information, this school last year had its 140th anniversary.
Yes, 2 years ago.
Two years ago. So it's a school that has been created in the 18th century, and the origin was a private institution, was not a public institution. The reason of this is that before the establishing this school, was created in Pesaro an important Accademia Agraria, and here we have the president of the Accademia Agraria. Io ti faccio la traduzione, non si usa nessuno, ma da altri. If someone else can help me, please. Okay, well, anyway, you are here, you can. The Accademia Agraria was founded 190 years ago. Well, now the presentation is given to the president of the Accademia Agraria, Franco Gambini, which is also a teacher in this school.
Grazie, buonasera. Potrei veramente al professore Colombi, che sa tedesco, adesso c'è il francese. Iniziamo a parlare in italiano e il professor Sotte mi darà una mano in questa presentazione. Quindi tanto benvenuti e la presentazione tra l'altro potete anche leggerla. Questo è l'obiettivo. l'obiettivo della nascita dell'Accademia Agraria, l'obiettivo che si pongono i soci fondatori, quello di incrementare la conoscenza del settore agricolo e di creare una scuola. Quindi iniziamo proprio già con poi la presenza di una prima cattedra e di una prima scuola.
Vado avanti?
No. By the major authorities of the city and other members of the nobility, especially landowners that had the interest and the scope to diffuse, to disseminate information, education between their farmers.
Okay.
So the idea to creating a school was a project of the Accademia since its foundation.
Okay. Quindi uno degli obiettivi, come ho detto prima, era proprio quello, no? Di incrementare e di fare, come dire, la struttura e il territorio, e per fare questo già da quei tempi la nostra Accademia ha cominciato tutta una serie di anche contatti con quelli che erano, diciamo, le altre istituzioni agrarie, non solo a livello nazionale, insomma, anche a livello internazionale.
So the idea to disseminate the information and education into the agriculture was relevant since the beginning, and the academy started having contact with other institutions, similar institutions in Italy and in other regions that at that time were founded as well in other places. The most important is the Accademia dei Geografi in Florence. Well, it's written there. Okay.
Luogo differente da quello dove ci troviamo oggi, perché poi la strada sarà abbastanza lunga magari le sedi saranno un po' diverse, però è il 1828 quando si inaugura la prima scuola di agricoltura a Pisa.
So, in the previous slide you have seen the front page of the first issue of the review. The Academia started in 1828 to organize a first school of agriculture.
Not in this school.
Not in a school, place. But in another place.
Okay. Facciamo diciamo, un salto molto ampio di anni, come ho detto prima, nel 1828 e 1876 c'è tutto un aggiustamento dei programmi. Però poi finalmente nel 1876 i marchesi Mosca vendono Villa Caprile, che è una villa con la possibilità di poter avere le aule per l'insegnamento teorico, ma anche è dotata di terreni per poter fare le esercitazioni pratiche, quindi Accademia Agraria decide di acquistare Villa Caprile nel 1876 per creare quella che è la scuola teorico-pratica con un convitto. Quindi già da allora ci saranno i primi 8 studenti che entreranno nell'ottobre del 1876 a frequentare la scuola anche con questo convitto.
In 1876 the Marquis Mosca was a nobleman of this city, sold Villa Caprile to the Accademia, and the Marquis Mosca, you remember that in this region the name is Marche, comes exactly because this was the region of Marquis. Was creating this school here after this purchase of the villa.
Diciamo che la villa resta proprietà della scuola fino al 1000 dell'Accademia fino al 1923, quando cambiano un po' di normativa a livello nazionale, quindi l'Accademia è costretta a cedere diciamo proprio anche la sua figlia diretta alla scuola, quella che era la mutata situazione anche a livello nazionale, quindi viene venduta la provincia di Belluno, che ancora oggi è la proprietaria.
Si
è venduta per quattro lire.
Perché
da una stima di 800.000 lire ne abbiamo preso 300.
So, well, in 1923, fascism started in 1922, just to locate the date. The school, that was a school of the Accademia, the owner of the school was the Accademia, was sold for very, very small amount of money to the province. The province is a public body, public institution. So the school ended to be private, and became a public school, but after a bargain, very, very, let's say, poor for the Academia, and rich for the state, for the public institutions, because it was paid very little.
Oggi l'Accademia si occupa di diverse cose, ma vedremo poi, ma un aspetto importante è quello della sua biblioteca e del suo archivio storico, dove ci sono raccontati e custoditi documenti della nostra storia, ma anche della storia dell'agricoltura locale, non solo, tanto che il nostro archivio storico è tutto catalogato, è stato anche conosciuto di particolare interesse storico per la sovrintendenza della regione.
The Accademia has a very important a very important archive, historical archive. You can imagine since the early 18th century a lot of documents have been collected in the archive of the Academia, as well as a library, as a bibliotheque, a public bibliotheque that is freely usable.
Come ho avevo accennato prima, secondo il professor Sotte, l'Accademia fa parte di una istituzione che è NASA, che unisce le accademie, non soltanto le culture, tutta una serie di accademie presenti nel territorio nazionale, e insieme facciamo parte, aderiamo dell'associazione che unisce le accademie a livello europeo. E tra queste accademie a livello nazionale ci sono le più importanti, come appunto l'Accademia dei Giacobbi, l'Accademia di Agricoltura di Bologna e l'Accademia di Agricoltura di Pesaro, che comunque insomma siamo tra le prime 3-4 accademie.
Accademia Agraria is a member of the UNASA, it's the National Association of Academies that have been founded here and there in Italy, especially in the north and the center. And the UNASA is part of a European Association of Academies, Agrarian Academies. In Italy, the most important academy is in Florence, Accademia dei Giacobbi, but the Pesaro Academy is between the most important similar initiative in Italy.
E oltre appunto a essere partecipe insieme a un'altra, insieme ad altre accademie, ha una serie di accordi di collaborazione per la comunicazione.
Variability since 1828.
Okay. diciamo, questa è ovviamente l'ultima considerazione che facciamo sull'Accademia Italiana, che facciamo oggi.
No, l'Accademia si è fatto quello che abbiamo detto fino adesso.
No, io non ho detto nessuno.
Quindi chiaramente si preoccupa di divulgare e di essere il filo conduttore tra il binomio tra le diverse istituzioni, visto che oggi da statuto non può più essere quella che si occupa della ricerca scientifica o diciamo, dell'insegnamento, perché ci sono altre istituzioni che nel frattempo sono state demandate a questo compito, ma chiaramente vuole disseminare e cercare di arrivare a più soggetti possibili, no? Quindi anche alla popolazione possibilmente, quindi attraverso tutta una serie di interventi, non ultimo anche attraverso il coinvolgimento con chi si deve occupare di professione della comunicazione, dato che l'anno scorso abbiamo fatto anche una convenzione con l'Associazione dei giornalisti agricoli proprio per incrementare sempre di più la possibilità di divulgare le informazioni del nostro settore. Io finisco qui, dico grazie del momento e poi passo a tutti i miei assessori.
Important initiative of the Academia has been recently an agreement signed with the Association of Agricultural Journalists in order to better disseminate and better cooperate in the dissemination of rural development and agricultural subjects. Well,
grazie per l'attenzione dagli studenti del 1900.
Thank you. Now the floor is to Andrea Biancani. Andrea Biancani is a member of the Council of the Regione Marche. We in Italy are organized in regions, and each region has its own government and its own elected assembly. He's a member of the assembly of the Regione Marche, the legislative assembly. The member of the legislative assembly of Regione Marche, and is responsible of the commission for environment. Okay, so thank you to be here. It's very important that we have such an important responsible for so important issues in our region. You have the floor. Sì, 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 sì. Abbiamo detto che sei arrivato preciso.
Oh, benvenuti e grazie di avermi invitato a questa iniziativa. Sì, sono il presidente della Commissione Ambiente della Regione Marche. E ambiente e agricoltura sono due cose che sicuramente devono andare avanti insieme. Ti ritengo di interrompere?
Sì, l'ho fatto
proprio su. Oggi abbiamo bisogno sempre di più di un'agricoltura sostenibile, cioè di un'agricoltura che da una parte deve considerare l'aumento demografico, quindi la necessità di dare risposta a nuovi milioni di persone che devono mangiare, ma dall'altra parte il problema del mondo di oggi è anche quello di cercare di fare un'agricoltura che sia rispettosa dell'ambiente, quindi l'utilizzo di una quantità d'acqua, ad esempio, compatibile con le reali capacità e disponibilità di acqua che abbiamo, o che non utilizzi, ad esempio, sostanze chimiche che quindi poi vanno ad inquinare l'ambiente.
Thank you for inviting me. Thank you for inviting me. Well, environment. I am responsible of the environmental commission on environment of the region Marche. Environment and agriculture must be together. Must cope with each other. sustainability is a crucial point. We have at the same time the need to feed a world of 9 billion persons in the future, so it is necessary to balance between two objectives that are at the same time relevant, feeding the world and make it sustainable. Matter is very important, the management of water as well as the use of chemicals in agriculture.
Puntiamo sulle, noi delle Marche puntiamo sull'agricoltura non di quantità, ma puntiamo sull'agricoltura di qualità. Siamo una regione che non ha spazi enormi e quindi puntiamo appunto sulla qualità del nostro prodotto e soprattutto cerchiamo di puntare sul biologico, sulle eccellenze del nostro territorio. Iniziative come queste, ripeto, secondo me sono molto importanti perché sono un momento di confronto, di condivisione per quello che riguarda quelli che saranno gli obiettivi, le politiche dei prossimi 10 anni. Noi saremo chiamati a programmare le risorse come Regione Marche, ad approvare quelle che sono le azioni che vorremmo in qualche modo sostenere per la programmazione 2021-2026-2027 e quindi avere la possibilità di confrontarsi anche con realtà scientifiche come le vostre per poter fare una programmazione, come dire, corretta è molto importante. Noi siamo fortunati perché abbiamo anche l'Istituto Tecnico Agrario, abbiamo l'Accademia Agraria nella nostra città, nella nostra regione, e quindi abbiamo anche due altri interlocutori, come dire, strategici importanti per farci fare una corretta pianificazione, una corretta programmazione. Chiudo dicendo che il mondo dell'agricoltura, perché l'agricoltura probabilmente viene sottovalutata anche da chi fa politica, andiamo a vedere quelle che sono, come dire, anche il reddito di chi oggi fa agricoltura, in molti casi è un reddito basso, quindi è difficile trovare chi è disponibile di dedicarsi nella vita a fare agricoltura. Però secondo me sarà inevitabilmente, dovremo cominciare anche a riqualificare, non solamente a pensare a fare in modo che l'agricoltura sia più sostenibile, ma lo deve essere anche per coloro e le persone che decidono nella loro vita di fare questo tipo di lavoro. Perché un'agricoltura fatta intensiva, fatta da proprietà multinazionali, probabilmente la direzione mondiale forse quella, però noi invece dovremmo essere bravi a trovare un modo anche per tutelare la dignità e rendere possibile sopravvivere anche chi invece punta a un'agricoltura diversa, un'agricoltura di qualità, quindi che comunque deve garantire a chi si occupa non solo dell'agricoltura, perché fa agricoltura, fa anche tutela del territorio. Gran parte del dissesto che abbiamo a livello nazionale è dovuto all'abbandono da parte delle persone di quello che avevano una volta, c'erano molte agricolture, oggi ce ne sono di meno, quindi sono molte terre abbandonate, e il fatto che comunque non ci siano più agricoltori crea un peso anche economico alla collettività, anche perché ogni volta che ci sono delle piogge magari eccessive, ci sono tutta una serie di danni che poi tutti dobbiamo ripagare. Invece dando più soldi, consentendo agli agricoltori di poter fare la propria attività, avremo la possibilità di avere meno danni, quindi meno danni ambientali. Grazie e benvenuti e ci vediamo.
We are in a region in which we have no large spaces. It's a region in which we produce agriculture of quality, and we target our agriculture of quality. It's a region with a broad diffusion of organic farming. Agriculture is important for our future, especially if it is supported by a continuous debate and discussion with scientific bodies. And fortunately, in this city, in this region, we have the Academia Agraria, the School of Agriculture, that is a great endowment of the region. Farmers normally suffer of low income, but we need agriculture because agriculture has also a role taking care of the land, of controlling and avoiding floods and other possible risks that a bad agriculture would produce, or the abandonment of agriculture could produce. So we need to requalify agriculture and try to move towards not an intensive agriculture that produces commodities, but towards niche agriculture that produces high quality food, giving then a sufficient income and incentive to young farmers to start with the business, with agricultural business. Well, thank you. Thank you. Grazie. Well, let me just add in conclusion also one comment of mine. When this is a region that was in the past a strongly agricultural region, and I just remember my students that in the 50s the employment in agriculture in this region was 60.2%, 60. Not 17, not 16, 60. After we experienced a very, very important industrial development in this region. And this is the region of the industrial districts. Pesaro is famous in Italy, but also in the world, for its industry of furniture. But in other part of the region, we have shoes industries or mechanical industries that have been created from the 60s onward to the 90s. But now these industrial activities pass a crisis, and the region has to ask itself which could be for the future the lever for a development of this region. I have to remember that this region, anyway, is a region that in Italy is first has been scored first as quality of life, depending on its capacity to maintain an environment sufficiently sustainable, a quality of its landscape. You will testimony tomorrow. This experience, and also this is a region of 45 theaters, because it was in the past the rent of agriculture was an enormous rent spent in creating nice towns and very nice places where the owners of agriculture were settled. Well, now for the future of this region, I think there are only what I teach in my class, economy of the apart from agricultural policy, but I teach a course in economy of the territory and the environment. Well, in the economy of the territory, regional economics, if you want, there is a important message that we have to send the student. Ask yourself which are the uniqueness of your place of living. These uniquenesses are the key for your future. Ask yourself what is unique in your region that is not shared with other regions. And I see two uniquenesses in this region. One is the centrality in the Adriatic Sea. Everything happens in Croatia, in Slovenia, in Bosnia and Herzegovina is immediately mirrored in this region. So we are very important If in our comparison with the rest of Europe in the east of the Adriatic Sea. But the other uniqueness of this region is really rurality. If we would be able in the future to establish, to start with a new definition of rurality, that is not only farmers or agriculture, but is the integration between agriculture, industry, and services in rural territories, with the quality of life that is linked to this tourism, for instance. I think that this is one asset that this region would must, in my vision, bet on. But this is the concluding message that I want to share with you. And if you are willing today, tomorrow, when you want, I'm very, very glad to discuss with you on this opportunity. What means rurality for the 20th, for the third millennium? What means rurality now? Remaining linked to the past. Past definition of rural equal agriculture, because we have to redefine what rurality is, and betting on rurality, I think we can also sell better the shoes, the furniture, and all the other products, industrial or coming from the tertiary service, the tertiary sector that this region produces. Now in the program there is the report of the event, the last event we have had in Spain.
So this is a magazine or magazines. We put aside the magazine each 2 months, and this is the last magazine with a picture of us and a few white pages of our meeting in Madrid. Well, for those of you that didn't come, we had a meeting in June, the 6th to 8th of June, and the topic was going local versus going European, two for solidarity, local trying in the EU, multi-level approach. And trying to achieve this topic, we designed the program that Jose has also there. Well, we did the meeting in three municipalities. We did it in San Lorenzo de Escorial, where we will stay, and we will visit the monastery. And we also stay in San Martín de las Iglesias and Colmenar del Arroyo, different municipalities of the region of Madrid. We achieved the goal of 101 participants, national and international. And we also had the presence of several mayors of the municipalities in Madrid that participate in different ways. The main day is... Well, we have a different conference in the morning, a Spanish conference with the General Director of Agriculture and Livestock of the region of Madrid. He talk about the research for the agriculture and also the research for the municipalities and evidence maybe the lack of information for the municipalities on knowing this research. And also we have the participation of the participatory local development strategy of the Sierra Norte of Madrid, the north of the region, and he talked about the different initiatives they have made in European levels. They share the experience and how they work and how they share they use the necessities of different items to use or to do put together the resources of different municipalities around some necessities. We also have the experience of the international experience, Romania with the Alpha country and also the Czech Republic, and because of the vast of loss and also because it took a lot of time, the two workshops that was planned, we couldn't do it, so we just made one. I think Russia is going to do the other one here. We did a workshop talking about